There are a lot of reasons why you could have large gaps at the bottom of a page or even within a page in a Microsoft Word document. In this video, we will look at the 5 most common reasons for these gaps, and of course, you'll also learn how to remove them. Before we start, let's just go to the paragraph section within the Home tab and activate the formatting symbols. By activating these symbols, we can immediately see whether there is a real gap between the paragraphs or if there are simply a lot of empty paragraphs that can easily be deleted. So let's look into gap reason number 1, the paragraph spacing. In Word, each paragraph can have individual settings for the spacing before and after the paragraph. To remove that spacing, we simply click into the paragraph before the gap, go to the Layout tab, and there we set the spacing values for before and after to 0. As we can see, there is still a bit of a gap, so we additionally check the paragraph after the gap. We do a click into that paragraph and again set the before and after value to 0. Actually, since this is a heading, we might want to have a bit of a space there, so let's set the value to 12 points. Reason number 2 for large gaps, especially at the end of a page, are advanced paragraph settings. On page number 2, there is a tiny paragraph that would definitely have space on the first page. The reason for that paragraph being on the second page is that this paragraph has a setting activated that ensures that the paragraph always stays with the next one. To deactivate that setting, we click into the paragraph, go to the Home tab, and in the paragraph section, we click on the little arrow in the bottom right corner. In the new window, we switch to the Line and Page Breaks tab and uncheck the box which says Keep with Next. After a click on OK, this paragraph is not tied to the next one anymore, and therefore it now jumps into the empty space on the first page. Now we can see that the next paragraph is still not starting on the previous page, and that is due to another paragraph setting. When we click into that paragraph and again open the paragraph options, we can see that the setting Keep Lines Together is activated. This setting means that Word should always try to keep all the lines of that paragraph on a single page. And since the full paragraph doesn't have enough space on the first page, it simply jumps to the next one. Once we deactivate that function and click on OK, the paragraph is able to split up, and therefore part of it will now start at the end of the first page. Reason number 3 for large gaps could be manual page breaks or section breaks. Such breaks tell Word to continue the content on the next page. With the formatting symbols active, you should be able to see the breaks. However, if the breaks are at the very end of a line, it could be that you only see very tiny dots as an indication of the break. So make sure to check the area in detail to not overlook these page or section breaks. In order to remove them, we simply place the cursor in front of them and press the Delete key on the keyboard. Note that the Delete key is not the same as the Backspace key, so make sure that you press the right one. Reason number 4 is again a page break, but this time we won't be able to see it on the previous page. This is simply due to the fact that the page break is integrated into the paragraph. With the formatting symbols activated, such a page break is indicated by a small square next to the first paragraph after the large gap. To deactivate that, we click into the paragraph and again open the paragraph settings and switch to the Line and Page Breaks tab. Here, we now uncheck the box which says Page Break Before, and we confirm everything with OK. And reason number 5 for large gaps is the setting for the vertical page alignment. On this page, for example, the content is vertically centered on the page. To change that, we simply click into that page, go to the Layout tab, and click on the little arrow in the bottom right corner of the Page Setup section. In the new window, we switch to the Layout tab, and where it says Vertical Alignment, we make sure that Top is selected. So these are the 5 main reasons for large gaps in Word. Let me know in the comments below which one caused the gap in your document. If this video helped you, then please support this free knowledge by hitting the subscribe and the like button. Thanks a lot, and I see you in the next one.